This is Gary Guymon with the Dominate the Day podcast. The purpose of this podcast is to help you get 1% better in your business, provide clarity, and give you some ideas that will help you grow your business. If you're ready to dominate the day, let's go.
Dominate the day. That's what we're about to do. If you don't want to dominate, then this podcast ain't for you. But if you are, then keep listening. Because every single damn day, the mission is, it's to dominate.
You already know.
We're here to dominate the day. So if you want to dominate every day, then let's go. It's time to grow. This is another episode of Dominate the Day.
So, you've been at this a while. Tell us some of the lessons that you've learned. What, one or two like things that come to mind as, these are really important for people to take away. And if they take heart with these, like it can really help them.
Well, I would say really to, for one, don't think you know everything because we don't know everything. We think we do, but we learn every day. But as you know, I had a company before this one, it failed. That company failed. We had the wrong business model. Our business model was built on volume. It was built on, advertising cheap prices, living socials, Groupons, all this stuff. And, we thought that we were smarter than everybody else. That, doesn't matter. We're gonna get repeat customers and they're gonna refer us and they're gonna get upsells, and that's not really the case. Yeah. So that company was very, very stressful. It was extremely stressful. I walked out of there in 2017, bought my partner out, got online, met you, and rebranded my company and came up with a whole new mindset. And that mindset was like, we don't want to advertise for cheap customers anymore. We want to advertise and get customers that are willing to pay, it's great money, but get a good value. Like, we're not ripping people off. Yeah. We're giving them awesome value. So I would say, people out there listening, if you have a service company, you think that to get the phone to ring, you have to lower your price. You have to be cheap. You need to rethink that, because that's a mistake that can sink you really quickly.
Yeah.
And it's a shame, because I see guys go down that path as times get slow. Because as business owners, we have roller coasters. We have roller coasters. And, I talk to people, and as the roller coaster starts to go down, they want to start just dropping their prices right away because they're afraid. I'm like, it's going to come back. Relax. It's part of the ride. You got to do some other things. Throw some value out there, Yeah. For me, hey, we'll throw a driveway cleaning with a house wash, whatever it is. We're not going to lower our prices.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I think that's what I would tell anybody. Just be careful.
So 2017 is when you rebranded. How long had you been doing that business model?
We've been doing it. We were doing that business model for about 5 years.
5 years.
Yeah.
So obviously, I'm going to guess some of the stress probably is related to customers.
Like, absolutely.
Because you got, your guys were incented to probably do as much as possible, and yep. So that cut corners. What were some of the other like stressors that came from that for the people that, because there's a lot of people listening that think, I lower my prices, everything will be fine. I'll keep getting work, and not understanding the things that go behind that are going to come out and bite you in the ass and make it stressful. So what were some of the other stressors that you had to deal with?
So employees was the second thing. You said customers. So employees, They are paid commission. So when they went out the door with their tickets, and if they couldn't sell for some reason that day, they just had bad attitudes. They weren't happy. So they wouldn't take care of our equipment at all. I mean, we had employees that would break equipment on purpose just because they didn't want to work. That's the other issue. When you're running at so small profit margins, when a transmission in the truck blows up or a machine blows up, it's a lot more tougher than now. You had to go buy a transmission, right? It's hard when your profit margins are so low.
Yeah.
Dealing with the volume of customers we were dealing with that were just coming in at one time, and they all just wanted this house washing deal. They didn't care about their properties. So we were getting the worst properties. We were getting the properties that looked like somebody just they weren't clean in 30 years probably because they really didn't care. The only reason they got it done is because they got a Groupon. They got a Living Social. They seen a truck for $149, a whole house wash going down the street. So employees and customers are definitely my biggest pain points, and obviously profits.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. The profits.
You brought up Living Social, man. We did a Living Social in 2014, I think, spring of 2014. Somebody talked us into it. Hey, it'd be a great. All these people are going to call you away from, you know, trying to get the Living Social, and you'll be able to upsell them. That was the furthest thing from the truth. It was the worst pricing model. That and Groupon, like, they're basically the same. The worst pricing model ever. And then you didn't get paid until like 60, 90 days later. And you said that, and I got like a pit in my stomach remembering those 3 months we were dealing with that crap. But, you know, it goes to the value that you provide as a company to your customer. And if you're shortchanging the value that your company provides by lowering your price, the customer's not going to see you as valuable either. I mean, it's a two-edged sword. Like, okay, so let's say your average ticket, or you know, you're going to drop the house wash price that maybe normally you charge $400 and you're going to charge $200. Okay. And you get five people to sign up for that in one day. Well, first of all, it's going to be a long ass day. Number one. Number two, you're not going to be able to provide the value that you can provide because you got a customer that's waiting on you to do that $200 house wash. And to the customer, the $200 house wash is the same value as the $400 house wash. And therein lies the problem. What do you think is the biggest thing that you were able to do to help you increase pricing or average tickets that eliminated having to worry about, you know, selling your price? Because that's what everybody talks. I got to sell my price. I got to sell the value. What did you do that helped you be able to increase average tickets without really just raising prices arbitrarily?
You mean now with this company?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So value, providing our customers with a, you know, from the whole customer journey, from when they call us, when they get the proposal, the whole step through, it's laid out very professionally. The value we give them, the steps we take during the house wash. You know, we don't just have an estimate saying we're going to wash your house. You know, it's really descriptive what we're going to do. We're going to cover your electrical outlets. We're going to take care of your plants. We're going to protect your property. You know, all the steps that we do, our final wash, all these different steps that we do that are extra. Now it becomes where, you know, you can't compare apples to apples, right? You can't compare this quote, my quote, with another regular quote because it's not the same. Yeah. And so I think value is really where it's been for us. And educating our clients also. I spend some time educating them because they don't know. You know, they think pressure washing a home is just pressure washing a home. They have no idea that it's not just pressure washing a home. There's things that can go really wrong when you get your house washed.
Absolutely. So we talked a little bit about the PWMCA prior. Anything else you got going on, any projects coming up or any speaking events that you're doing that you're focused on making happen or maybe another type of project that that's going on that you want to tell us about?
Oh, right now I'm working on next year's annual, but besides that, you know, I am working on something, trying to get it panned out to do something down there in like the Kentucky, Ohio area. Trying to do an event down there. So one of our awesome vendors in the industry, I'm not going to mention right now because we haven't ironed it out. So I don't want to get anybody angry, but we're working on getting that done. And then, that'd be great. Give guys opportunity to learn and network. And, you know, I had a really good conversation with a buddy of mine last week, and you got to get him on the podcast, man, Paul Gianni out of New York. You know, he came to my Myrtle Beach event in 2000, I think in 19,
yeah,
may have been 20, but I think it was 19. He's up in New York. He said, look, I've never been off of my island. I've always been here. And he has a nice little company at the time. He goes, I came to your event. He goes, the people that I met changed my life completely. Now he has a really successful growing company, and he told me that he runs his company. He's like, I run my company now like I have no arms or legs. That's the way. That's the mindset I have. That's how my company's ran. Because I was out taking down Christmas lights last month, and he called me. He's like, what are you doing taking down lights? I'm like, because I like to. He's like, no, man, no. He's like, I've now run my company like it has no arms or legs, where I'm not touching anything like that. And this is somebody who's been in business for a while. He's been in business for a while. He came to an event. He never thought he had to go to an event. He came to that event, and he was like, just blown away. So now he's a really big supporter of the events now. Because it really opened his eyes, man. Because these events aren't about, all these events out there aren't about, oh, I'm going to go there and this guy's going to tell me how to spray bleach or whatever you do, how to cut grass or how to clean air ducts. These events are all to meet new people, learn new techniques, and build relationships that can really help your business.
Yeah, I think the piece that people miss the most is the connection that you make with others in your industry and the things you can learn from that. The things you can gain from that, I've been fortunate that, I've met some people outside of events, but at the same time, there have been a lot of people because of events that I've met. Dave Carroll, Kurt Kempton, those are two people that the relationship started at an association event. And, Dave is probably, if I'm saying, hey, who are some of your closest friends? Dave would be one of those people. And it was because of an event. And I've learned from him. He's learned from me. You can't take away the value, or you can't understand the value that holds until you experience it. And people think, like you said, it's something else, right? They think they're going to go there and they're going to learn how to do something better, and you will learn how to do something better, but it's probably not going to have anything to do with the actual work of your business. It's going to be either about yourself or how to do a process better that helps you do something. Paul saying that he doesn't use his arms and legs. I mean, he is creating a business, not a leveraged job. A lot of us have a leveraged job to where we have to show up. We have to be available. Maybe we're not out in the field, but if we're not doing the work, things don't get done. And that's, to me, that's the biggest focus of any business owner that they should be really pursuing, regardless of how big you want your company to be or not, is get a business that can operate without you all the time. And it's possible. Number one, it's a mindset thing. And number two, it's giving trust to people that you've put in place to be able to be successful. And that's the hardest, to me, that's one of the hardest things we do. I made 2023 the year that all the processes that are done in my business, I don't have to do. Now, I've removed myself from probably 80% of the processes already. It's my strategy. We have meetings on a weekly basis. We talk about what we're testing, what we're doing. Like, I do all that, but I used to do the majority of the work. Now, like, the only thing I really do is sell. And this year, the goal is I don't want to be the person selling. And, we added someone in January who, she's the first person that's ever sold a client for our company that wasn't me. And it's crazy. Like, it's a good feeling. But what Paul is saying is creating something that you're not needed. That's a business. And and that's the kind of stuff you can learn by hanging out with different people at these events. I mean, and then like some of the speakers you had this year, Santi, like he's, I mean, who doesn't he speak for? He's one of John Maxwell's speakers, correct? I think. And then he works in Howard's organization. Like, guy's intelligent. And you could sit there and take just a little bit from what he said, implement your business, and see some changes. So my advice is get to an event, like at least do one a year, you know, and take your team, like take people that are on your team that are valued members of the team that have invested into being there and give them something to look forward to and to like work towards so that they can see, okay, there's more to this. There's more to this than what we're doing. And I mean, if you haven't been to an event, get to one. If you have been to one, but you haven't been to the PWMCA, get to the PWMCA. I mean, come on. What other event has someone singing Party in the USA at a high level for karaoke? I mean, do you know of any, Jamie? Because I don't know anybody.
I don't know. Yeah, it's good stuff, man.
So cool, man. So tell us how people can get in touch with you, where they can go find out more information about you and the stuff that's going on.
Yeah, so if they want to find out about the association, they go to pwmca.org. If they just want to follow me and just check me out, I'm Jamie Schmidt. I'm on Facebook. I have a couple groups. I'm in Pressure Washing Motivation is my group. I'm in a couple of Gary's groups. So I'm in all the Facebook groups and a lot of industry. So I'm around. But if you want to learn about the association, pwmca.org is the place to go, and tells you all about it there. And we're growing, and we got some pretty cool resources coming this year, which I'm pretty happy and stoked about.
Absolutely. Yeah. Get there. Check Jamie out. Man, get to the event. Like, if you're a home service business owner, regardless if you're in exterior cleaning, carpet cleaning, dryer vent cleaning, not cleaning, junk removal, like whatever, get to the event. There's a lot of good resources there that can help you. And inside of the organization as well, inside the association, a ton of good stuff. So go check them out. We'll have those in the show notes. Jamie, it's been a great time hanging out. Dominate Nation, go remember, dominate the day. And I'll be talking to you guys soon.
Dominate the day. That's what we're about to do. If you don't want to dominate, then this podcast ain't for you. But if you are, then keep listening. Because every single damn day, the mission is, it's to dominate.
You already know.
We're here to dominate the day. So if you want to dominate every day, then let's go. It's time to grow. This is another episode of Dominate the Day.